in Luke chapter 24, after Jesus has risen from the dead, he's walking with two disciples on the road to Emmaus. They're kept from recognizing him, and they're brokenhearted over Jesus' death. And they tell this to the stranger who's walking with them. Jesus, in response, tells them that everything that has happened is a part of God's plan. In verse 27, we read, "And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he explained to them everything that was said in the scriptures concerning himself." Jesus goes through the Old Testament, and he shows how the whole thing testifies to him. Even though his name is never mentioned once in the Old Testament, when you come to understand the gospel of Jesus and how his life, death, and resurrection has saved us from our sins and given us eternal life, you hear the echoes everywhere in the Old Testament. Take, for instance, King David, the greatest king in Israel's history. In 1 Samuel 17, David is still just a shepherd boy, and Saul is the king. David's father sends him to bring food to his brothers who are fighting in a battle with the Israelite army against the Philistines. While David is there, he hears a huge man named Goliath taunting the Israelites, mocking their God. Goliath challenges the Israelites, saying in verses 8 to 9, "Choose a man and have him come down to me. If he is able to fight and kill me, we will become your subjects. But if I overcome and kill him, you will become our subjects and serve us." Goliath is what is known in those days as a champion, literally in the Hebrew, a man between. He tells the Israelites that he is fighting as the representative of the Philistine army, and he's looking for someone brave enough to oppose him as a representative or champion of the Israelite army. And if one champion wins, the whole nation wins, and the other nation will become their slaves. David hears Goliath's taunts, and he seethes with righteous indignation as he sees this Philistine mocking God. David goes to King Saul, and he volunteers to fight Goliath. He rejects the king's armor, choosing instead to come against Goliath in weakness. He takes 5 smooth stones with his sling, and he approaches the Philistine. And after they exchange some words, David slings the stone into Goliath's head, killing him, saving Israel, and bringing fame to himself. Now, there is a lot to be learned from this passage about courage, about zeal for the Lord, about keeping your eyes on Jesus and not on your own weakness like Saul, or on your own strength like Goliath. And many people teach this story like this. Who are the Goliaths in your life? Debt? Cancer? A difficult marriage? How has God prepared you to defeat them? And how can you look to God and find the courage to defeat the Goliaths in your life? But here's the thing. You are not David, and David does not point to you. Remember that David fights Goliath not just for himself, but as a champion of Israel, the representative of the people. He doesn't fight to inspire them. He fights in their place as their savior. And by David's victory, everyone in Israel wins. David, in his victory as the champion of Israel over Goliath, doesn't point us to how we can overcome debt or a bad marriage or whatever other struggles we're facing. No, David points to Jesus, the greater savior. You see, Jesus also came in weakness, just like David. But by his life, death, and resurrection, Jesus defeated Satan. And his victory becomes our victory over sin and death, even though we never lifted a stone or fought a battle. You are not David. You are the cowering Israelites, unable to defeat Goliath by yourself. Jesus is the greater David, fighting the battle for us, defeating the enemy, and giving us his victory. As Paul writes in 1 Corinthians 15:22, "For as in Adam all die, so in Christ all will be made alive." By David's defeat of Goliath, every Israelite was saved, even though they never lifted a rock or a sword to fight. And by trusting in Jesus' life, death, and resurrection, we have been given eternal life, despite our inability to defeat Satan on our own. That is what 1 Samuel 17 is all about.